Hello, fellow alchemists. Welcome back to our series on learning Elixir and learning Postgres. Today, you see, we're trying a different setup, so please let us know if you enjoy it or not. Leave a comment below. If you haven't, please subscribe. And we're going to have a lot more interesting videos as time goes on. But today, I wanted to go over expanding upon more of what we did last time. So last time, we kind of hooked up to a channel, and we were just sending simple messages across. Now I wanted to really use more of Postgres and show you guys how we can solve a little bit difficult problem and how we can leverage the database to do this for us. And so, for instance, we did a recent project where we wanted to notify people that a message was deleted. And the difficult part came in the fact that if you deleted one message and that message was related to another message, then you need to be able to go back. And if this was the case where you have a message and then you had about four or five children and then those children had children, it would get very complicated. But with Postgres, you can actually tell it to cascade delete. And in that case, it would actually recognize all of those messages that are about to be deleted and actually broadcast that to you. And so this is how we set up everything. So before this video started, I went through and actually created all the code. And I'm going to walk you through how this everything works. So the way the first part works is I just modified our existing PG listener to listen to this chat message deleted channel. I created a message. And the message, of course, has a message, the text. And again, this is simplified. And all I wanted to do is add just the message ID. And so, this is the other message that's been related to. And of course, I added that to the casting so that way we can have a message that's being kind of like a reply to another message. And I created a migration, of course, for that messages table. And this is a little bit of the secret sauce. There's many sauces to this mix. And this one is when the related message gets deleted, then we want to delete all the messages that are related to that message. And then finally, I had to add in this function of notify. So we add in this create or replace function and give it a name. It has no arguments. And we're returning this as a trigger. And I'm not too sure too much about the syntax of this, but what I do know is that we have this beginning and end, and we need to declare that what kind of language we're using, because you can use different languages to create functions within Postgres. We're just using this PL PGSQL language. And what we do is we do this perform PG notify. And of course, PG notify is similar as the notify we did before with notify listen. We have to state the channel name and a string syntax. And then I'm doing this JSON build object over here with a message over here, and then another JSON build object. Again, these are functions within Postgres, and just defining the ID. And we're using this old.id. So when you have functions, you have this ability to have old and new. So if you're doing something with the update, you have the old data and the new data. So in this case, we're just using the old. I don't think there's a new when you delete something, but I may be wrong. And I just make sure that this actually comes from a JSON object to just being text. So it'll just come off as text across the channel. And of course, we have to also define if we ever want to roll back this, just drop the function if it exists. And then finally, we have to connect everything together. And so we have to actually create the trigger, give it a name. And we have to give it an event. So before we actually delete this record, we're going to, on the messages table, for each row it's going to be deleted, we're going to perform this notify chat message deleted. And so that's just going to run this function over here. And of course, if we ever roll back, then again, we also want to drop the trigger. So it's pretty straightforward. Now we're actually going to run this. So when we migrate our database, we're going to create the table and also create the function and create the trigger. So now when I run my app, and I actually go to, so I'm just going to pattern match and just grab this record over here. And I go to create a message, test message. And now if I try to actually delete this message, you'll see that before it gets even deleted properly, we will send off the notification to tell people, and you see it's actually coming in what we defined over here, right? Message with an ID over here. Now the real test is if we start to have that cascading problem, right? And so I'm just going to create a simple cascade, just a child and a just a parent and a child, to kind of show you how this works. And so the first step is I'm going to, of course, create that message. So we have a new one. You see, it's ID of 2. And now, you don't need this part. But what I do need is I need to set the message ID, and we're going to use the previous one. And you'll see over here that this message with an ID of 3 is related to the message ID of 2. So now, if I go to actually delete that message, you'll see two messages coming across, one for the parent and one for the child. So here's the parent getting deleted. And finally, here's the child getting deleted. And we can easily react upon this, right? So that's kind of really the power of using Postgres and this PG notify, is that for complex interactions that may be happening, we can easily catch this stuff using triggers, using the functions, using PubSub, and we don't have to worry about all the potential complexity that can come about from this. So this is Alan from Plangora. Please subscribe if you haven't. Otherwise, I'll catch you guys next time. Thanks. Bye. Hi. Please feel free to ask us any questions about Elixir, Flutter, or anything else in programming. Here's our YouTube channel, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. We'll answer your questions every Friday. Ya mantai ge duck man all. Yo wenti ji do wen wo.